A sweet old lady asked me to build her an elevated plant bed. So today I'm building her an elevated plant bed. First, I'm gonna measure and cut every single piece for this project. Here I'm cutting my legs. I'm using 2x4s to cut 4 legs 24 inches long each. You can see I'm marking all of my 90 degree cuts with my blue triangle to ensure everything is square. I'm using pressure treated lumber, which is only necessary for outdoor projects. It has an ugly greenish tint to it, but later I'll stain it for a nicer, warmer color. Now I'm using 2x2 pressure treated pieces that will connect the legs on each end, making an X design. This not only makes it structurally more sound, but it'll also help dress the piece up with a simple design. The top horizontal piece attaching the legs will also help hold the bed of the planter. For all my projects, I use SketchUp to design and draw out everything so I know the exact measurements and angles of every piece. This makes the rest of the project run much more smoothly. In this project, I need to create an X within a 9.5 by 11.5 inch rectangle. This works out to where I need to create a 40 degree angle squared off with a 50 degree angle, so the end of each piece will be centered and square on each corner. Now I'm cutting pieces to create the walls that will surround the planter bed. Here I'm using 2x10s, and you'll see my saw is so small I have to make this cut with 2 passes, one on each side. I have upgraded my saw since then. What I don't show in this video is I also cut notches out of the corners of these pieces to allow the 2x4 legs to run past the bed to allow them to attach to the walls above. You'll see this as I assemble everything together. All the pieces are cut and ready to assemble. The 2x10s are for the walls and the bed, the 2x4s are used for the legs, and again the 2x2s create the X's on each end. Next, I'm going to drill out all the necessary pocket holes for this bed. I use the Craig pocket jig, and it's my favorite tool in my toolbox, and something I use for every project I build. The pocket jig allows me to build this entire piece without any screws or screw holes being visible in the end. Once the pocket holes are created, I'm able to begin assembling. The most satisfying part of any project is watching it all to come together. First, I'm going to assemble the legs by using exterior grade screws, and I'm also using a bit of wood glue to help sturdy up the piece. Thanks to the pocket jig, all the screws will be hiding on the inside. Next, I'm assembling the base of the bed. The pocket jig allows me to fasten these two boards side by side. You can also see the notches cut out of the corner, which will allow the legs to run past inside the box, but they'll be covered by the soil. Now I'm assembling the walls that will wrap around the bed. Again, to ensure no screws are visible on the outside, I use the pocket jig to fasten everything from the interior. Now that we have the walls, bed, and legs assembled, let's put them all together. Here I'm attaching the legs to the walls. Since the legs are attached from the inside of the box, I'm using a board as a spacer at the bottom of the legs to make sure everything stays square. I'm using a large drill bit to allow the screws to countersink into the wood. Then using an impact drill to fasten it together. The frame is assembled and I'm going to place the bed inside. The fit was very snug, so I have to hammer it into place. Now that everything is assembled, I'm going to create a few drainage holes in the bed so water is able to escape the soil to prevent it from rotting. Now that it's all built and sanded and clean, the bed is ready to be stained. Here I'm using a 2-in-1 exterior stain and protective coat, and I'm applying it with a cotton rag. You can apply it with a brush usually. I don't know why I'm using a rag, honestly. This stain will give it a much warmer hue and get rid of the ugly green color of the pressure treatment. Once the piece is completely covered, we are all done. A year later, I came back to look at some happy and healthy herb plants, living the dream in the plant bed that I built. Thanks for watching.